In this video tutorial, I'm going to show you how to resize your images using the GNU Image Editor, more commonly known as GIMP. It's a free image editing program that's very powerful. You can download it from gimp.org. Okay, so I've opened up GIMP and it's over here. And I've got this image here. It needs to be a bit smaller to fit on my web page. This is a common mistake that's made by many new web designers. They'll take a photo in their camera and they'll just upload it straight away and then resize it on the website. That's a bad idea because the file is still large and takes a long time to download. You should first resize your image before you upload it. So you can open up your image by clicking File, Open, and then browse for where your image is. And then to resize it, all you need to do is click Image, Scale Image. And I'll just tell you what these settings mean. If it's a photo, it's probably around about 300 dpi. Change it to 96, which is what computer screens are. And then a good size for an image on the page is normally 320 pixels wide. And don't worry so much about the height, but that'll fit on most web pages. And then you click the scale button. And now our image is the right size. So let's save it so we can use it on the website. Click Save As, and most photos do this really abstract number name for the photo. We don't want that. We actually want it to be a human readable name. So if this was a Tractor Model 551, I'd call it the name of the company, Beatty Tractor 551. Also notice how I'm using an underscore instead of spaces. This just makes it easier for the internet to read it. And then of course it's a JPEG image. Even if it wasn't a JPEG image, we want to save it as a JPEG image because that's an internet standard. And you'll see here that there's all these different image types that we can save as, but we save as JPEG. And then just click the Save button. And it'll say what quality compression do you want to use, and 90 is fine, and then we click Save. Then all you have to do is upload that to your website. The next stage that you might want to use is being able to click on that image to show a larger image. To find out how to do that, go to the Spinning Planet YouTube page, which is youtube.com/spinningplanet. I'll just show you. youtube.com/spinningplanet. And then on the right hand side of the page, you'll see all of our video uploads. Click See All. And then you can either search all of our videos, there's over 100 up there, but this is the one you want to watch. On click, Show Large Image in Lightbox. And that's it for this video tutorial.